नमस्ते टू ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, माई सेल्फ जीवन डॉक्टर खुशबू वर्मा फ्रॉम फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रिकॉम्बिनेशन प्रोसेस इन डिटेल एंड व्हाट इज रिकॉम्बिनेशन। सो टू डीएनए मॉलिक्यूल्स एक्सचेंज डीएनए जेनेटिक इंफॉर्मेशन रिजल्टिंग इन द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ न्यू कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एलील्स। This process is known as recombination, and this process creates genetic diversity at the level of the gene that reflects the differences in the DNA sequences of different organisms. Crossover basically is the result in recombination, and the exchange of genetic material between the maternal and paternal chromosome is done by the crossing over result. As a result, offspring can have different combination of genes than their parents. Recombination can occur both during mitosis and meiosis, and recombination may also occur during mitosis in eukaryotes, where it originally involves the two sister chromatids chromosomes formed after chromosomal replication. This is the crossover during meiosis 1. This is maternal chromosome, this is paternal chromosome. So crossing over is going to done at the two places, and this region will be exchanged by the maternal and paternal chromosome. So that's how crossover will done. And if we talk about the types of the recombination, so there are homologous or general recombination, non-homologous, site-specific, and replicative recombination, or you can say transposition will occur. Here you can simply see in the homologous recombination, this is A plus B plus C, here A minus, B minus, C minus. So this region will be exchanged like A plus but B minus and C minus, here A minus but along with B plus and C plus. In the non-homologous, crossover will be done here, and A, B, F means F will go here and C will go here. And in the site specific means this region is having ATT, and it will go and it will create two regions, ATT and ATT, and the gamma region will involve or incorporated in between both ATT region. In the replicative recombination or transposition, this is the transposable element, which is also known as transposome. They can move from one side to the other side in their chromosome region. So here this is the transposable element, and transposase enzyme will be involved in this process, and the transposable element will move from this side to this side. Now we can discuss here in detail, like homologous recombination is extensively studied in E. coli, and at least 25 proteins are involved in the recombination in E. coli. It is based on sequence complementary base. Next one is a non-homologous recombination. It occurs in the region where are no large-scale sequence similarities apparent. In the site-specific recombination, it occurs between particular short sequences present on otherwise dissimilar parental molecules. Good example are integration of some bacteriophage such as lambda into a bacterial chromosome and rearrangement of the immunoglobulin gene in vertebrate animals. The integration of bacterial, viral, or plasmid DNA takes place. Next one is the replicative recombination, which generates a new copy of a segment of DNA. Many transposable elements use the process of replicative recombination. Reciprocal recombination, it is equal exchange of genetic information, the process resulting in new DNA molecules that carry genetic information derived from both parental and DNA molecule. The number of alleles of each gene remains the same in this product of recombination, only their arrangement has changed. Next one is a gene conversion or non-reciprocal recombination. One-way transfer of genetic information resulting in an allele of a gene on one chromosome being changed to the allele on the homologous chromosome. the transfer of genetic material from a donor sequence to a highly homologous acceptor sequence. This is the gene conversion. Here B minus is also converting into the B plus, and this is A minus and this is already C minus. Now come to the models of four homologous recombination. So classical analysis of recombination. So in each chromosome, the genes are arranged in linear series and corresponding groups of genes are exchanged in crossing over. Each exchange event involves only two chromatids, one from each chromosome. The Holliday model. So in 1964, Robin Holliday proposed a model that accounted to heteroduplex formation and gene conversion during recombination. He mentioned single-strand inversion, an endonuclease nicks at corresponding regions of the same strain of homologous chromosomes and generates by the nick invade the other homologous duplex, and ligase seals nick to form a joint molecule, and branch migration expands heteroduplex region. Next one is the resolution of joint molecules can occur in one of two ways. The Holliday junction can be nicked in the same strands that were initially nicked. So this is the sum up of this session, and this session is powered by digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University Jaipur. If you have any query, then mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.